Good Saturday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a quick check of your weekend forecast. Things are looking relatively okay as we go toward the area around Sunday, but unfortunately, as we get into Saturday, it's a good possibility you're going to need more rain protection out across the Mid-South, as we've been seeing drizzle out there and could see some thunderstorms throughout the rest of the day. So please keep that in mind. Also, for travel purposes, wet roadways. We've already had a couple of accidents early this morning, so please plan ahead for that. Slow it down, windshield wipers, headlights on, the whole thing. Let's make certain we're paying attention out there for what may be heading your direction. Rest of the day today, Beale Street Music Fest. We'll see some scattered showers out there, maybe even a rumble of thunder, but the good news at this time is that severe weather is not showing up at this point. Early this morning, pretty quiet, but definitely going to be a more active Tom Lee Park as we get into the rest of the day. Rainfall amounts from early this morning showing up as about a half an inch of rain around the University of Mississippi in Oxford, and about a third of an inch at Heidelberg Elementary. These are the largest amount of precipitations that we can see across the area. And again, doesn't look like much, but that is definitely enough to slow things down, especially on the roadways. So please keep that in mind. Rest of the forecast, again, going to be seeing the storm system down toward the Gulf Coast make its way over toward Florida and do a pretty good job of stirring up more chances of showers and thunderstorms as it passes on through. Once it leaves the area, that's where we see, again, the chances of rain greatest over toward Knoxville, Atlanta, east of Huntsville and Birmingham, all the way up into and around the Chesapeake Bay area. And that's where we'll see, again, the heaviest amount of precipitation out that direction. But not too much for us, as we see, again, the potential for drier weather with that area of high pressure making its way on through much of the Mid-South. Now we've got another cold front making its way into the area well back to our north, and that one is going to be possibly causing some more problems as we go into the forecast toward next week, late next week, as we see again that potential for stronger weather heading our way. Now again, with anything happening in the Mid-South today, mainly just rainfall, but we could see again some showers and thunderstorms just about any place across the Mid-South mixed together. If anything turns strong to severe, keep it tuned to News Channel 3, and of course, we'll keep you advised on that. Severe weather chances as we go into the weekend. The main threat for severe weather at this time appears to be well on down to our south. We're just not picking up too much of anything here directly in the area. Thunderstorms, yes, that's that pale green color that you see there, but the bright green color and the yellow, that's where we see, again, that potential for a slight risk of severe weather. So New Orleans, up toward Atlanta, down toward Birmingham, that's where the main threat is going to be for later on today and into this evening. Updates on that forecast that you're looking at will bring you more details throughout the rest of the day on social media. And then as we go into the next couple of days, back to our northwest, that is where we're going to be looking at the potential for more chances of severe weather well back up to around I-70. But we'll continue to monitor that as that storm system gets a little bit closer to us. By about Thursday or so, that's where we may see that potential for more chances of severe weather coming into the Mid-South, again, late during the week. So a brief respite from the rainfall from Sunday through about Tuesday, and then some more changes heading our direction as we get into late next week. Rest of the day today, temperatures back into the mid to upper 70s. In some locations that don't get the rainfall, clouds and rainfall sticking around for much of the Mid-South should be back in the lower 70s, looking at some light northerly winds. Not that much of a problem across the Mid-South for right now. Again, with that rainfall, outdoor activities may not be the best thing for today. It's Star Wars Day, so heading out to a matinee of your favorite Star Wars chapter, or free comic book day if you're heading out to the comic book store to support your local comic book store and local businesses. Take the umbrella, make sure that you're protected from the rain, and again, keep it tuned to News Channel 3. We'll keep you updated on what goes on out there. Asteroid Day is coming in 56 days. What does that mean? Well, we'll talk more about that coming up later on tonight on social media, so stay tuned for more on that and how you can participate. And of course, stay tuned for my forecast on Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3. We'll keep you updated on the radio throughout the rest of the weekend. Currently in the Mid-South, again, in progress for the first weekend of May. Quiet and so far soggy, but hopefully clearing up as we go into the rest of the forecast. So stick around for more on that here on News Channel 3 on air and online. We'll keep you advised. And, of course, if anything turns severe close to the Mid-South, we'll keep you updated on that as well. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Stay tuned for much more with News Channel 3 on your weather forecast throughout the rest of the weekend. And thanks for joining us for this morning's edition of News Channel 3's video weather blog, Weather Overtime.